Hey guys, welcome to another episode of a Skillers vlog. As you probably remember, we ended last episode with 31 mining and 41 woodcutting. And the first thing I decided to do after that was head to the cabbage patch for the April Fool's event. I wanted to get the cape just so that we have something to wear, so we're not looking so newbie all the time. And it's pretty cool to have a skill cape after just a few days of playing, so yeah, if you guys didn't get to the event in time, don't worry, it'll be back next year. So after getting the cabbage picking cape, I headed to Thessalia's store in Varrock and traded in the frog token from the first episode for the frog mask, just because I thought it would look pretty cool with our cabbage picking cape, and it did. So now we are looking pretty sweet, guys. Alright, so after accessorizing for a little while, I headed to the teak tree southwest of Castle Wars, just to get my woodcutting level up a little bit. Now, I did bank all of the logs, which is kind of makes it a long process, but since this is an account where I'm trying to keep all the resources that I gather, I decided to bank them with the Ring of Dueling. If I wasn't trying to hoard all of the resources that I gathered on this account, I probably would have just dropped the logs for some fast woodcutting experience. But yeah, that is what we did until level 51 woodcutting. After that, I decided to start fishing in Drainer Village just to get a break from woodcutting a little bit. So what I did was from levels 1 through 5, I fished shrimps, and from levels 5 through 20, I fished sardine and herring, and from levels 20 to 25, I switched back to small fishing and caught shrimps and anchovies. After getting level 25 fishing, I teleported to Camelot and started fishing for cod just north of Sears Village Bank. After just a few minutes of fishing for cod, we got our first genie random event, and since we are a skiller, we obviously want to use our genie lamps on Slayer, since that is the only way I'll be able to level it up. So what I immediately did after getting the genie lamp was I headed to the Varrock Museum and completed the mini quest in the basement that will get us to level 9 Slayer and level 9 Hunter, just so that the genie lamp will be a little bit more effective. So after finishing up at the museum, I headed back to our fishing spot just north of Sears Village. And since I got level 30 fishing before I went to the museum, we switched to fly fishing trout and salmon for a little bit faster experience. I did this until level 38 fishing. At level 38, I switched to catching rainbow fish. If you guys want to know how and why I caught rainbow fish, I made a guide and I will link it in the description for those of you who are interested. I did rainbow fish until level 40 fishing, just so that once we start the fishing trawler, we will be able to get a little bit more experience per hour by being able to catch lobsters. While we were doing that, I got another genie lamp, which I also used on Slayer, and it actually boosted us to level 10 Slayer, which is great. That means if we wanted to, we could wear a face mask to kind of show off, like, hey, we're level 3 with 10 Slayer. But what I'm probably going to do is hold off until level 15 Slayer, at which point we'll be able to wear earmuffs, which are a pretty cool item in my opinion. Alright, so after getting level 40 fishing, I decided to head to the Motherlode mine and just catch up on mining a little bit. Since we did start at level 31 mining, what we mostly got was coal and a few gold ore. I stayed here until level 41 mining just so that we could use our rune pickaxe once we decided to come back. After finishing up with level 41 mining, I decided to head to the fishing trawler just to get the angler's outfit for a little bit faster fishing experience. I actually managed to get the first three pieces, the hat, the top, and the legs, in like the first 10 games of the fishing trawler, and I didn't actually get the boots until like another 20 or 25 games after that, so that was kind of annoying. But we did get the complete set, which is awesome. Our guy is starting to finally look like a skiller, and we are making some good progress. I also thought this was pretty hilarious, guys. We actually managed to get 10 crafting just from repairing the trawler net. Alright guys, so here's what our gear is looking like after this episode. We got the full angler outfit, and I got a crossbow with no bolts, just in case we accidentally attack something, we won't actually get any experience because it won't let us shoot. And here's what our bank is looking like, guys. We've made a lot of progress. It's looking pretty good. We've got a lot of placeholder items right here that we can hopefully get quite a few more of. But yeah, guys, it's looking pretty good. I'm happy with this so far. So if you guys like the video, be sure to give it a thumbs up. Leave a comment. I love to hear you guys' feedback. And make sure you subscribe to the channel. Thanks so much for watching.